This video is going to be about ratio and proportion. So let's start with an example and get an understanding of what some of this vocabulary, ratio and proportion, means. Let's say I've got a photograph, and the photograph is 3 inches, we'll call that the width, and the height is 4 inches. Well, I can compare the width and the height as a fraction. I can write the fraction 3/4 and say that the ratio of the width to the height is 3 to 4. In other words, in comparing two numbers, I can write them as a fraction and read the fraction as a ratio, the ratio of one number to the other number, so the ratio of the width to the height. Now, there are other ways to write this. Instead of writing as a fraction, sometimes you'll see something like this with a kind of a colon sign in between. And this is still read as 3 to 4. And sometimes people will just write out 3 and the word 2 and 4. So these three things mean the same thing. It's the ratio, in this case, the ratio of the width to the height. Now, let's say I want to enlarge the picture. And I don't want to distort everything. So I'm going to want the ratios to be the same. If I make the width 6 and I make the height 8, then I'll have the same ratio of width to height, because the ratio of width to height in this case is 6/8. And I can reduce 6/8 as 3/4. Now, if I compare two ratios, if I write 3/4 equals 6/8. I've got what's called a proportion. In other words, I'm saying these two ratios are the same thing. Okay, so let's see what we can do with that now. Let's say once again that I've got this picture, and the ratio of width to height is 3 to 4, and I want to enlarge it, and I want the width to be 9, and I'm wondering what will the height be. So I'm going to call the height x. Well, I can set up a proportion. I can say the ratio of the width to the height, in other words, 3/4, is going to be the same as the ratio of the width to the height, or 9/x. And now I just have to solve this equation. Well, remember, when I have an equation and it consists of just two fractions, I can cross multiply. So I'm going to do that. I'll have 3 times x is 3x. Whoops. 3x. And that's going to equal 4 times 9. 4 times 9 is 36. And now I'll just divide both sides by 3. These 3s will cancel, and I'll get x equals 12. So the height of my picture is going to be 12. And of course, we can check that. We can take 3/4 and see if it equals 9/12. And if we reduce 9/12, we'll divide the numerator and the denominator by 3. We're going to get 3/4 equals 3/4. So this will work. Now remember, when you set up a proportion like this, you want to make sure that you're comparing the same things. In other words, in this case, I've got a width on the top of my fraction, a width as a numerator, and a width as a numerator, and then a height as a denominator, and a height as a denominator. Let's look at another one. So let's say I've got a recipe. This is a recipe for soup. And the recipe says, take 2 cans of soup and mix it with, I don't know, 3 cups of milk. I have no idea if any soup is made like this. So I can say that the ratio of the cans of soup to the cups of milk Well, that didn't work. The ratio of the cans of soup to the cups of milk is going to be 2/3. This is soup, this is milk. And somebody says to me, well, I've got these 5 cans of soup and I want to use them all up. How much milk should I use? Well, I'll make a proportion. I've got 2 cans as my numerator here. I'll put 2 cans as the numerator of a fraction here. And my denominator is going to be how much milk I use, how many cups of milk. So here I've got 3 cups of milk, and I don't know how many cups of milk I want. So now I've got a proportion. I'll cross multiply. 2 times x is 2x. 3 times 5 is 15. I'll divide both sides of my fraction, both sides of my equation by 2, so these will cancel, and I'll get x equals 15/2, which I'm going to make into a mixed number, and that's going to be 7 1/2. So I'm going to need 7 1/2 cups of milk if I'm going to use 5 cans of soup. Now, I just want to do this one more way. Remember I said you want to compare the same thing, so we have cans and cups. I could also compare them. I could put the cans like this, 2/5. The ratio of the cans in the first recipe to the cans in the second recipe would equal the ratio of the milk in the first recipe to the milk in the second recipe. Okay, so take a look at what I have here. This is cans and cans, milk and milk. This is cans and cans, milk and milk. Okay, I'm going to cross multiply and I'll get 2x equals 5 times 3 is 15. So this is the same thing I had before. I would divide by 2 on both sides. I get x equals 15/2, which is 7 1/2. Okay, so the main idea is this. When you're setting up your proportion, you want to have the ratios being comparable. In other words, if we've got a ratio of cans to milk, then we have to have the other half of the proportion is cans to milk. If we've got a ratio of the small recipe to the big recipe, the small recipe for cans and the big recipe for cans, then we want the small recipe for milk and the big recipe for milk. Okay, so I'm going to follow this up with another video basically about using ratio and proportion with triangles, because they're pretty popular questions that you run into in your math course. Okay, so that's it for this one. I'll be back in a minute with a new one. See you soon.